Next topic is EZ notification. I am going to discuss about the EZ notification. First, what do you mean by E? The word E is hails from a German word, Entgegen, which means trans. EZ stands for Zusammen, which means cis. So, if the two groups are higher priority or on the opposite side of the double bond, the bond is assigned to be a E configuration. Similarly, if the two groups are of higher priority are on the same side of the double bond, the bond is assigned to Z configuration. So we have to naming a E conformer or Z configuration. So priority is based on the how to find given the priorities. The priority is based on atomic numbers. So iodine is highest atomic number, then bromine, chlorine, SH, OH, NH2, CH3 and H. So hydrogen, you know well, it's a least atomic number. Iodine is highest. This is a given the priority of compounds. So next CH2Cl, similarly CH2Cl, CH2OH, CH2NH2, CH2CH3 and CH2H. So this is the order of priority we can give in the double bonded compounds. Now let's start with an example. So how will you give the E or EZ conformer configuration? So now let's split into two part. So highest atomic from first we are concentrated this side. So which one is highest priority? Methyl is highest priority. Hydrogen is least priority. Here methyl is highest, hydrogen is least priority. Now the highest priority are opposite side, so it's a E configuration. Okay, so next example is, so we split into two part. So methyl is highest priority, hydrogen is least. Here methyl is higher and hydrogen is lower. So the highest priorities are in same side, so is it Z configuration, Z. So next example, now we are split into two parts. So chlorine or bromine is highest atomic number. Bromine is highest priority, then chlorine. Here chlorine is first and hydrogen is least priority. Now the highest priorities are opposite side, so we can give the E configuration. Here chlorine is we split into two parts. Chlorine is highest priority, then methyl. Here methyl is the highest priority, ethyl is highest priority, methyl is lowest priority. So highest priorities are in same side, therefore it's called Z, cis configuration. Here another example, chlorine is highest priority. We split into two parts. Chlorine is highest priority, next is fluoride. Similarly here this will be highest priority and this will be lowest priority. So the highest priorities are opposite side, therefore it is E configuration. Are you able to understand? I think you are understood from these examples. So next topic is RS notation. So R means rectus, the R means rectus, which means right side, that is clockwise rotation. Similarly S is sinister, this word hails from German, and which means left, that is in anti-clockwise rotation. It is a nom, the RS notation, it's a nomenclature to specify the configuration of chiral molecules. On the base of the nomenclature, this molecule is represented either R or S. The system was introduced by Kahn and Claude Prilog, CIP. These names are scientist name, so CIP rule. So first we give the numbering. So numbering is based on priority, as I said before. So from numbering is based on atomic number. So here bromine is highest priority, next ethyl, third one is methyl, and finally hydrogen. Because bromine is highest atomic number, C2H5 ethyl is highest atomic number, followed by methyl and hydrogen. Now the numbering will be like this, and the order will be this direction. So it's a anti-clockwise direction. This is anti-clockwise direction. So we put it S configuration. Okay. So next, similarly, can give the next compound. Bromine is highest priority because it has highest atomic number. Next ethyl, and third methyl, finally fourth will be hydrogen. So what the direction will be? Clockwise. So it's called, the notation is R, rectus, right side. This is left side, so yes. So this is the RS notations. So we can go for next topic. So next topic is conformational analysis of cycloalkanes. So what do you mean by conformational analysis? The different spatial arrangements of the atom that results from rotation about a single bond are called conformations. A specific conformation is called conformer. So let's start with cyclopropane. So this is molecular structure of cyclopropane. We can write, we can also write this kind of formula. So another one is Sagar's formula, Newman projection formula. This is a way of writing of Sagar's formula for cyclopropane, CH3CH3. Similarly, the Newman projection is like that, CH3 and CH3. This projection formula is called eclipsed. So the CH3 will be eclipsed in eclipsed form. So this is called eclipsed. And another one is staggered form. The CH3 are 60 degree rotation. So this is the way of writing a Sagar's formula for cyclopropane in staggered form. This is Newman projection formula. Now we straight away we go for the conformational analysis of cyclobutane. So this is a potential energy diagram of cyclobutane. So from eclipsed to eclipsed, so totally eclipsed. So we start from 0 degree, just we rotate the 60 degree and 60 degrees. So 60 degree, 120 plus 60, 180, 240, 300 and 360 degree. So first we take the eclipsed form of cyclobutane. So this methyl group at adjacent position. Now we rotate this part, this front part, to 60 degree. It will be go like this. So this form is called Gauche form. This form is Gauche form. Next we rotate 60 degree. 60 degree will be eclipsed form. Similarly, again we rotate the 60 degree. So methyl position is in exactly opposite direction. This position is called anti position, ANTI. Again we rotate the 60 degree. It's going like this. It's a eclipsed form. And again we rotate 60 degree up to 300 degree. So it's a Gauche form. And finally we rotate 60 degree, that is 360 degree, a completely totally eclipsed form. Okay. So of this, the eclipsed form has more energy, and the Gauche form is very less energy, and the anti form is very least energy. So from this diagram we can understand the potential energies of cyclobutane in different forms. Okay, the corresponding energy values are given here. So we just rotate the 60 degrees from eclipse to eclipse, that is 360 degrees. So this is a potential energy diagram of conformational analysis of cyclobutane. Okay, thank you.